So the time to see if two given vertices are connected. Well, if we can access every element of the adjacency matrix in constant time, well, then we can just check that given element in the matrix in constant time. Similarly, the time required to add an edge between two vertices, well, we can access that element in constant time and then just change it from 0 to 1. That's constant time. And similarly, we can change from 1 to 0 to remove an edge between two vertices. Now, the time to find the degree of a vertex. It's a little bit harder to find the degree of a vertex, where the degree is the number of vertices that are connected to it. In order to find all of the vertices that are connected to a given vertex, well, we have to go down that row or that column one by one. Since we have to do this n times, well, this is order n at least. Now, these questions are somewhat tricky. The memory required to represent a graph with order of n edges as an adjacency matrix and order of n squared edges as an adjacency matrix. This is a bit of a trick question. If we have n vertices, then we have an n by n matrix, which is n squared total elements. So we're going to need n squared memory slots to put each of those elements in. You can pare that down a little bit if you're really clever, but with a naive adjacency matrix approach, then the memory required isn't really a function of the number of edges so much as it is the number of vertices. So we're going to go ahead and put n squared for both of those.